Welcome back to Demon's Souls Fanatic 2, this time for Oubliette. So like in a different tame map, or like some prison or something. More grey and brown, I mean. Then this mod takes inspiration from Quake. It must be grey and brown. That's kinda the only complaint about I would have about the design of this level, but it looks good. And this secret is really a tease. The way to open it is really not obvious, we'll be seeing it later. Difficulty is still kind of the same, fighting Kaku Demons, Revenant, and Train Gunners. Difficulty doesn't increase too much towards the levels, unlike other mods and stuff. Or the later level are just brutal and the first level is dead easy. Progression is good, but having a pretty uniform difficulty levels is also good. You don't have to wait until the later levels to actually have fun. And here you have to take this sphere to progress. And in this case, I'm not really fond of the sphere, since you're in close quarter. It's useful against these kind of enemies, but against anything else that fire projectiles, it's not that good. Like right there! He was trying to shoot somewhere else! But no, got shot in the face. And since you kind of cross crater, this map is actually harder, so the amount of enemies is kind of the same. I mean, the composition of the enemies is kind of the same, but the layout of the level makes things a little harder. You don't have that much space to dodge, but yeah, you do fine. There's a pretty nice secret there. Hey! Falut guy. Fun. I guess the maker of this mod has played Fallout 3 as well. I mean, Oblivion was good, sorry. To progress to the next part, we have to go into these two ways and find two switches. Again, there's no case in this mod, like the first one. And you have to earn switches instead. It's kind of the same thing. Since this map doesn't really look a map where you can find doors, which open by keys. It makes a little more sense. And you can do more creative stuff with switches than with keys. Sneaky bastard. There's again a lot of ambient sounds, which sound pretty nice. And here I was trying to make the monkey pie wake up, so he would infight with these guys, but actually failed. One bad thing about this mode now, you can play every map from pistol start. I like doing that. Like, you know, in Megawatt and some other mods, you can play the map you want from the start with nothing. So you don't have to replay the maps before it to play your favorite map. It's not too bad because there's not a lot of maps there. But yeah. I like pistol start. And a lot of maps from most Megawatts are intended from pistol start. Because as in every weapon and every map is winnable with pistol start. It's harder, sure, but in the way, when you have ammo stacks from 20 levels, it's so dead easy to start with a BFG and max ammo. Scavenging some health there. Going to the second, to the second switch. Oh no! It's a trap. Half-Life-like music usage again. It's not too tense there if you know it's coming, but if you just rush through and have the door closed and having these two monkey by and imps and everyone shooting at you, it can be really bad. Oh, hey, Berserk Pack back. Even if Berserk Pack is not that useful there, you get it pretty much always, which is good. Because I like Berserk. And as you can see down there, there's a secret, which is in fact two secrets. And showing player that the secret exists and you can find it is very good. It's much better than having secrets behind walls that you have no idea they exist. There's a few doors in this mode, but I mean, not all of them are like that. Good placement for an autosave there. Because this part is actually pretty tricky. You'd be stuck if you got that secret there, but yeah. You can be stuck if you don't kill the knight to make the exit open. And I made some error, I didn't press the switch. Yeah, and I think I forgot about that and I come back to see, oh wait, the door is not open. The demons are very annoying enemy in big maps, because when you shoot them they go flying backwards for long distances. But in close maps they're actually nice to fight because they're big ass targets. And they're too dangerous. You don't have too much F either. Like less than an L Knight. Okay, now for that secret down there. Oh yeah, I realized I didn't press the switch. Good job. I'm fisting in anger in the air. I'm that angry. You're greeted by a nice Ashrai. Hey, what's up, Ashrai? It's not very dangerous because since you have plasma gun and you've been given plasma ammo before, it's not bad. Okay, here, to open the secret down there, you have to attack that wall, and it throws this. I had no idea. I found it just by chance. First time to go there, I had to rocket jump in the secret, which is not the intended way. But this map is very generous in health and stuff, like here we're back at 200-200 again, for the second time. That contemplates the fact that most enemies are power enemies like Revenant, Monkey Bye, and this kind of stuff. Which again, not a too bad problem because you're pretty stuck on ammo too. And that's a good usage of demons. Demons are really pushover when you see them coming from far away, but when they ambush you in close spaces or just teleport right next to you, they actually are a little dangerous. And here you can get murdered by these guys if you get in a crossfire there. Another friendly Ashrai. Can be much more dangerous there because he has actually good corpses to resurrect. And there's actually a new gib animation for imps in this mod. As you can see, Ashrai's being brought on gibs. Which is kinda cool. Some mods like Beautiful Doom have a lot of change for like dying animation, every time you shoot someone there's blood that spills everywhere, new effect, but I think that's just too much. I don't like Beautiful Doom myself. I'm fine just with the pedestrian sprites and sound effects. I like my Doom clean. And in this area there, there's three different floors. And that this is again the use of 3D floors. There's no way to do that in our Doom. I don't know, I have 3D floors and teleporting places, like in TNT, like you walk somewhere and bam, teleported somewhere else to simulate the effect of 3D. That makes the automap very useless. Here the automap is still a little useless, but since it's up and down, yeah, it's not very a big problem because the map are well made. While the first mode was pretty classic, this one is a little more Quake-oriented, or Gothic, I don't know. It's more grey than brown, and Quake was all about brown. So I guess it's a mix between, yeah, two genres, two styles. Here I'm trying to find one lost source that yeah, it's there. I failed to see what it gone. I don't know what I was doing there. Oh well. And for some reason, down there at the start, there's demons spawning. You may not want to go back there, because here is where you want to go. I'm going to kill them anyway, because of course I want maximum kills, but there's no real point to that. Having spectres in this area where you don't see much and the walls are mostly grey, it's a good use of them again. And having them in bright rooms with colorful walls, or you can see them coming from miles away. I wish spectres didn't do any sounds, that would make them much more dangerous and sneaky. Here's another Ashfry again. Again, this is a good use of Ashfries because they don't spawn like 4 Ashfries in you like some mods do. It just spawns at some regular places with few enemies to resurrect and that's it. It's not too dangerous. Also, there's nice decoration there. Statues and some other thing I don't know the name of those. Very good. Without being over detailed again. Well, I like detail and like Tormentor maps. It's too much is too much. I'm being worried of guys on the side there because there's a tricky thing there. When you fight these guys, I think, or maybe after that, yeah, there's an automaton spawning behind you. Yep, here he is. If you don't pay attention, I mean, you probably won't notice this guy because he spawns silently. You're going to get murdered again. Trying to fight like 5 Mancubi. This guy just goes behind you and, oh hey, what's up? Good thing there's a secret there before the next part. I don't know if this level does damage to you, but I was kinda worried of it anyway. So what's going on there? There's ammo, save scroll, health. Nothing's going to happen there. I'm sure of it. Nah, nothing's going to happen there. Just a decoration. Just a room where I had parties and, I don't know, feast. Oh, maybe not. So welcome to the first encounter. There. You can have the boss fight. You have to defeat the Ashfry to win. At every race, the Ashfry is got out of the invulnerability state. And you have a few seconds to shoot him and damage him. And after these few seconds, a new wave of enemy will spawn. And you have to kill them all to go to the next wave. You have some music from unknown band. It looks like another band now. I'll name it there. That cutter is good, it's kind of fun. But if you don't know how to deal with the Rush 5, the first time I did it, I was. What the fuck is going on? How do I fucking finish this? He made the rifle too long. The best way to fight the Ashra is this way, just shoot it there with the Blast Magnet. It has a shitload of F now, some way. The Blast Magnet is only a really good weapon to fight the Ash Vibe between waves. Rocket Launcher doesn't put it in pain state, and yeah, it goes back into a resurrected state right away. And now we begin to escalate, a set of shotgun guys who have shotgun gunners. It's going to get worse and worse, so you really have to kill the Ash Vibe as soon as possible. Zack will soon get a safe score just before the fight, because you're going to need it the first time you fight it. And here the music stops looping, and doesn't loop again. So you won't hear like 10 or 20 times, like again, in changing maps. As the way the Ash Fight goes back into its energy state is really random, so it can fuck you over very hard. They are not doing that good because I demonstrated shooting it with the rocket launcher is a very bad thing. I don't want it to die too fast too, so you could actually see the escalation. But yeah, that's my only complaint about this fight. If you don't know exactly what to do, it will drag for too long. It's not extreme now, but still. Should not last much longer than the music. Maybe a one-liner or some indication that you have to shoot Ashra would be a good thing. Not too much for one-liners, but... well, would have been useful for once. The same way in the TNT first episode, you didn't know that the Spider Mastermind and the Duo Raigun Arachnotrons were invincible. You had no way to know it, except wasting all your ammo for 3 minutes. And here it goes down. Awesome. So last time to pack up what's left in there and move on to the next map. I will see you then.